We're at the Magic Johnson Alonzo Mourning. Was it pool tournament, poker tournament? What? You know, what? Where in the hell are we?
I just found out that you play it with a stick. I was doing it all wrong, so I don't know nothing about it. But I'm between two journalists. I don't like the journalist sandwich.
I'm standing here, of course, with Arsenio Hall and Stephen A. Smith. Stephen A., he's been on my show, Washington Watch. Yes, Arsenio hasn't been on yet. Yeah, he will be on. So, gents, how we doing?
I'm doing wonderful, man. I can't complain. You're looking dapper as always. The scarf, everything like that.
You know, come on, brother, got to rock the ascot.
Do what you do. You do it well, Roland. You do it well, my man.
Let me ask both of you something. One of the things that we're focusing on with our show this week, dealing with athletes and philanthropy, and it's so amazing because you hear people say all the time, "Oh, they should be doing more." But does the average person really understand the stuff that a lot of these athletes do off the field, off the court?
I don't believe that people do, but at the same time, I do believe the athletes on a lot of occasions have an obligation to showcase some of the things that they do, because if you are a role model and people are watching you and what you do, then maybe you need to show them what you do. And I say the same thing about the hip-hop industry. I'm glad you got my man right next to me, because one of the things that I've said, I've tweeted about this, I've said this publicly, I remember I've told Snoop Dogg, Ice Cube, and all of these guys, the hip-hop industry, they don't owe anybody anything more than they owe this man. Because this man right here, Arsenio Hall, was the one that was putting them on national television when nobody wanted to touch them. And he made them mainstream. And he used to highlight a lot of the things that they were doing. So what happens is that it's the same thing that you can say about professional athletes. It's not that you want to sit there and brag about what you're doing. What you want to do is what Zoe and Magic are doing tonight. Setting the example, publicizing the fact that this is what we do, this is why we do it, and this is how you need to go about doing it so you know better.
Arsenio, what about that, guys? Because some people say, look, I'd rather keep my stuff private, the visits I make to hospitals, things along those lines, as opposed to always putting it out there. Because some say, you know what, I don't want it to seem like I'm bragging on myself or I'm trying to show I'm a goody-two-shoe. What do you think about that?
Well, first of all, I remember back in the day we did a same gang summit where all the gang members decided we were going to do nothing. And it was spearheaded by the rappers, by Tupac and Queen Latifah and different people. I remember telling Queen Latifah, Bill Cosby gives a lot of money to colleges silently. And there are a lot of people who talk trash about Bill Cosby because they don't know and he don't care. But I think it's really important, like Stephen says, that you do some things publicly, because as much as you want to be classy and not let anybody know what you do, your fans need to know you're a good person.
Well, let's take that to another level. He brought up Bill Cosby. Bill Cosby comes out and he says some of the things that he says about the African-American community, and people are in an uproar and literally were calling him a sellout. And I'm sitting there, it's like, if you count the dollars that he's contributed to our community, excuse me, he might call you a sellout for blowing his money. It's unbelievable how people turned against him. I'm not saying that he didn't come across a bit harsh or whatever. I'm saying when you have that kind of heart, when you make that kind of contribution, that gives you the right to have a little disgust inside of your soul when you feel like people are wasting the opportunities you've helped provide.
Hey, there's a guy dogging Bill Cosby at Spelman or someplace in America that probably went to school because Bill sent him money.
Absolutely.
And Bill don't put no name on the money he sent.
Exactly.
Who would you say, athlete that you know of today, who is on the forefront of the public policy issues, things happening in the streets? I would say Eitan Thomas is one of the guys who actually is out there doing this sort of thing. Is there any guy, any athlete you can think of who is fighting those kind of fights?
No.
Like those guys did?
No.
And that's, by the way, this goes to them doing things publicly again, right? Because we should have a list of names.
Exactly.
But sometimes there are people doing things silently and we don't know. So that's why they need to do it publicly, so we'll have a list of names next time you ask that question.
It goes deeper too. Eitan Thomas is a great name. Alonzo Mourning is a great name.
Dikembe Mutombo.
Dikembe Mutombo. Magic Johnson. But you said current players.
Right.
And what happened is that you have corporate America telling them this is not financially beneficial to you. And then they wonder why the resentment of the old players come cropping up. The reason why is the old guys are saying, we sacrificed ourselves, our careers. We put everything on the line to take the stance that we took. That is what enables you to do it. We were scared to death and broke having second jobs while playing professional sports, but we did it anyway. You got $50-100 million in the bank, and here you are afraid. How cowardly can you be? And that's a valid point. It's a valid point.